Hey guys, it's Jeff Gelman of Solid Canine Training with another episode of Man in the Arena. What the heck is Man in the Arena? It's a new series. It's something I decided to do that talks about real issues, real cases, real situations that us as a board and train, but also you as a dog owner, or you bring home a foster dog, or you bring home a brand new dog, and it sort of talks about like, what would you do? And it's not a ours is better than yours, or what you're doing won't work, but it's practical solutions to problems which usually have to be stopped immediately, or number one, it will be dangerous, someone will get hurt, the dog could get hurt, or your life will be a living hell. So here's a common situation that happens at our training center. We primarily do board and train, we primarily deal with difficult dogs. Let's talk about separation anxiety. Now a lot of my colleagues, a lot of people will know, and a lot of dog owners definitely know, separation anxiety can destroy your life. It makes your world really, really small. You're not able to do things with your dog. Some people can't leave their house. Some people can't have a full-time job. Some people have massive destruction to their property. Dogs jump out windows. Dogs bark all day. They're being possibly potentially threatened with eviction. So let's talk about this situation, which happens all the time. We have a dog come in. One of its issues is separation anxiety. They can't even keep it in a crate. Well, you'll notice that all dogs have to be kenneled up here because we can't just have dogs running free during downtime and nighttime. So, and then you can also add in human aggression to that if you want to. So now we've got a dog, day one, it comes in and it has a history of breaking out of crates. So if you put it in a inexpensive crate or those wire crates, they can destroy those and get out of those really quick. If you put it in a really, really tough crate, which we have many of them, what happens is they can't get out of them, but they can destroy their teeth. And we do get dogs that come in here already with missing teeth. And for some weird reason, they don't care. You can come home from work and all of a sudden it looks like there's a murder scene, and it's because the dog was trying to get out of the crates. Massive panic happens, a lot of stress, a lot of anxiety on the dog, but also on the human. It's really, really difficult to live with a separation anxiety dog. So we cannot have barking dogs, whining dogs at night. We cannot have dogs trying to break out of crates at night. I mean, that's why also they're here. So you have to resolve, at a minimum, the act of trying to get out of the crate. So the mental issue, the psychological issue, you can actually work on a little bit, but the physical issue of breaking out of the crate, you have to stop. So, man in the arena, what do you do when a dog comes in and night one, all it wants to do, because it has a habit, a practiced behavior of breaking out of crates. You put it in an inexpensive wire crate, it destroys it. You put it in a tough crate and it can break its teeth. Meanwhile, it's barking and whining the whole time, not only stressing itself out, but also stressing out all the dogs, you know, in the kennel. Like right now there's 8 or 9 dogs in kennels, but listen, it's quiet, and all these dogs came here for issues. Some of them just arrived yesterday. Some of them arrived this week. Some of them have been here for a while. So what do you do? Question, how can you stop a dog from breaking out of crates immediately? Not, you know, we're gonna work on this on a week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks. Now you're gonna obviously, remember, we're not talking about teaching obedience command. We're not talking about getting rid of aggression. We're talking about the physical act of, we're not even talking about like getting rid of separation anxiety. We're talking about we have to stop the physical act of breaking out of crates tonight. It's a situation that we deal with more than half the dogs that come in here. We have to stop it immediately, or else chaos ensues. Man in the arena, we're in the trenches, we're doing the work, We have to be successful. Failure is not an option. We have to get the dog physically to stop the act of breaking out of crates, whether it's stressed out or not. And then we can start, like, obviously going down the road of obviously rehab. What do you do? Because a lot of you are out there are struggling on this. Jeff Gelman, Solid Canine Training, manning the arena. We're doing the work, we're in the trenches, and we wanna help you have a better, bigger life with your dog. We want you, the human, to have a less stressful life. And the way we do that is by helping your dog stop its nonsense, and then you can start having a better life. I'm madly in love with you, and I cannot wait to do another one. Leave your comments below.